I'm Mary Yusan, and this is Humanities Highlight of Women's History. March is Women's History Month, a month-long celebration dedicated to women who challenged gender norms and left their lasting legacy in history books. We take this time to reflect and commemorate the achievements and contribution to women. And today, we shine the spotlight on Connie Chung. In the journalism world, Connie Chung has left her mark in the history books by becoming one of the first women to co-anchor CBS Evening News, and the first Asian person and the second woman to anchor one of America's major newscasts. She's the daughter of a Chinese diplomat and a DC metropolitan native. Upon graduating from Montgomery Blair High School, Chung went on to pursue a degree in journalism at the University of Maryland College Park. Immediately after attaining her bachelor's degree, Chung began her career as a journalist at Washington's WTTG-TV. Ultimately, she worked her way up to reporter. 2 years after becoming a reporter, she was hired by CBS News to work as a Washington-based correspondent. Her big break came in an exclusive interview with President Richard Nixon. This interview was amidst the Watergate scandal. During the next several years, she began to gain traction by becoming one of the most popular journalists in television news. Her popularity led her to relocate to Los Angeles, California, where she became the lead anchor for local CBS affiliate KCBS. It was during her tenure at KCBS where she started a relationship with Maury Povich. Chung and Povich were old acquaintances from their days as co-workers back in Washington, D.C. at WTTG. The two dated for 7 years before they married. It was another 18 months after their wedding that their careers allowed them to live in the same city together. In 1986, the newlyweds relocated in New York City. During the height of her career, she announced that she would be leaving her grueling work schedule to focus on having a baby. This announcement came as a surprise to all and was only months after the launch of Face to Face with Connie Chung. Her efforts to conceive a child were unsuccessful. After several unsuccessful attempts to get pregnant, Chung and Povich decided to adopt. In June 1995, they adopted their son, Matthew. Connie Chung has shattered expectations and broken down barriers throughout her career. She is an award-winning journalist who continues to inspire women to work hard and continue to strive to achieve their dreams. In the words of Connie Chung, "I don't know what all of us can do to continue to press for more women, more minorities, but it's just something that we all have to work on." I'm Mary Yusan, and that's Humanities Highlight in Women's History.